Hi, I'm Tim from Scoop. With a variety of cable available to the networking industry, it's important to know which type of cable to use for your installation so that you ensure overall network performance, stability, and speed. In this video, we discuss Ethernet cable and the most common standards used in the industry and network deployments today. Modern Ethernet is based on the principle of using four twisted pairs inside a single cable jacket. The twists are clearly visible when physically inspecting the pairs inside the cable. These twists are significant to prevent a phenomenon known as crosstalk, which essentially is the occurrence of electromagnetic interference across the line. Each pair uses different twist rate per meter, which further facilitates noise rejection, and cables are split into different categories commonly known as CAT rating. This identifies cable characteristics such as twist rate, wire thickness, anti-crosstalk properties, and shielding. Most importantly, it defines the overall bandwidth capability on each category, which takes all factors into account. In order to improve bandwidth capacity for each cable type, you will generally need to increase the wire thickness and use a higher twist ratio per pair. This means that as the cable capacity specification improves, it becomes more rigid, making it more challenging to install. Let's take a look at some of the most common cable categories available. Cat5e is arguably the most commonly used category of Ethernet cable in South Africa today, and it's capable of up to gigabit speeds under 100 meters. The reason why it's so popular is that it's cost-effective, easy to install, and to terminate. It uses 100 MHz of bandwidth without additional crosstalk division. If we look at Cat6, it's capable of gigabit plus speeds up to 100 meters, and even 10 gigabits up to 55 meters. It uses 250 MHz of bandwidth to achieve the speed and is a good choice for modern installations. However, its increased cable thickness requires a bit more skill to install, and the RJ45 connectors are not as easy to crimp as with Cat5e. It's also worth mentioning that you should never use Cat5e RJ45 connectors on Cat6 cable. Next, we have Cat6a, which offers even greater transmission speed at 10 gigabits per second up to 100 meters while using 500 MHz of bandwidth. These cables should be used in high capacity LANs with 10 gig switching environments. Finally, Cat7 and Cat8 take speeds even further up to 40 gigabits per second, but demand for these cable types are significantly low when compared to the rest, and for this reason, we don't stock these products for now. Generally speaking, Ethernet standards dictate that twisted pairs should be made from pure copper. Vertical and horizontal cable installation should be done with solid core cable, whilst fly or patch lead should use stranded copper for more flexibility. Thickness is outlined using the American Wire Gauge Standard, or AWG for short. This determines the minimum core diameter of each wire. Scoop's Linkbasic cables are made from pure copper at the thickest possible variant, which translates into complete peace of mind that you'll be able to get the best performance out of your hardware. For Cat5e, it's 0.5 mm, Cat6 is 0.565 mm, and Cat6a is 0.575 mm. This is why we're able to confidently recommend using Linkbasic cable for every installation. Copper-clad aluminium or CCA cable, on the other hand, is drastically cheaper due to aluminium cores, which are mini-plated with copper opposed to being pure. Although not ideal, it makes for an attractive price proposition, but how does it compare to pure copper? First of all, copper is stronger than aluminium. This means that copper can handle higher pull tensions when installing, so there's less chance of damaging it. The aluminium in CCA has higher voltage resistance, which means power over Ethernet, or PoE, will be affected more than solid copper. If you choose CCA cable, make sure that you're using a power supply with enough voltage to accommodate the extra loss in power. In our view, the biggest benefit to using CCA is cost, and to appease the price-conscious market segment, we stock a full range of CCA cable under the Scoop brand. If you're unsure whether your current cable is copper or CCA, simply scratch the surface on one of the cores or check the supplier's datasheet to confirm what you're buying. Cable structure can be categorized using a simple method of characters to define their use. For example, UTP stands for unshielded twisted pair, while FTP stands for foil twisted pair. Unshielded cable is mainly used indoors in a dedicated cable sleeve. In open runs, it should be kept at least 1 meter away from electrical cables to prevent interference, which will cause packet loss. If you are sharing sleeves or running directly across power cables, you should use shielded cable. FTP shielded cable has a foiled sheath around the twisted pairs. This helps to reduce electromagnetic interference or EMI from outside sources. Most will contain a drain wire which is used as an earth conductor to help redirect any charges that might have affected the line or connected devices. Shielded cable will generally provide a more reliable connection for devices at risk from electrostatic discharge or ESD. This is the cable you should use for outdoor wireless installations carrying PoE. For this to be effective, shielded RJ45 connectors are required to be crimped to the ESD drain wire on each end. We stock a wide range of UV protected shielded cables and have a pre-terminated option to save you time and hassle. Bear in mind that wireless devices would usually only require Cat5e due to sub-gigabit speeds in most situations. Regardless of which cable you choose, we hope that you found this video informative. If you enjoyed our video, please give it a like and subscribe to our channel for more content. For more information on our products, check out the links below. Thanks for watching. I'm Tim from Scoop.